Welcome to the Lumbridge Knight, Romeo and Juliet quest guide for Old School Runescape. All you need for this quest is some Cadava Berries and about 15 minutes of time. That said, some energy potions and a high agility score will definitely come in handy. This is a very simple quest for 5 easy quest points. Welcome to the Lumbridge Knight. Remember to subscribe and like our videos if you don't want to miss out on any of the hints, tips, tricks and guides that we're going to be bringing you on this channel. So without further ado, let the questing begin. Okay, so as you can see by the map, this quest is located in the Varrock region. In and around Varrock, you don't have to go very far at all. And you start the quest by speaking to Romeo. So here's Romeo. This is a pretty long piece of narrative, so as you can see, I've kind of sped things up a bit. There's also some really irritating person. I guess they're trying to train their magic by doing rock teleport over and over again. So apologies if the teleport sound gets really annoying. But anyway, we're going to help Romeo here with his love life. Obviously, it's, you know, the classic cliche, Romeo and Juliet. He's just told us there that Juliet's father hates him and is going to kill him if he sees her again. Therefore, we're going to go to Juliet and try and act as a bit of an intermediary. So without further ado, as you can see by the map, this is Juliet's house. It's northwest Varrock, as if you're going to the barbarian village. It's on the west side of Varrock. Head as if you're going to the barbarian village. And it's the building straight after the bank. There you go, you can see it there. So open the front door, head straight upstairs. Again, I've sped this up because I'm walking. Go through there, through this next door, and there's Juliet on the balcony. Speak to her. She'll, you know, explain that Romeo's in love with her and wants to be with her and all the usual romantic nuance. And she'll say that she actually likes Romeo as well. He's a bit of a weirdo, but she likes him. And hopefully, around about now, she will give us a message that we can then deliver to Romeo that confirms. There we go, there's a message. Confirms she feels the same. And they just need to get round her father somehow. So we're gonna hightail it straight back to Romeo. Again, I'll be speeding the video up. And he's in Varrock Center Square, obviously where the video started. And there he is. And we're gonna give him the letter. He's gonna read the letter, or I'm not sure if we actually read it for him. You can read through all the dialogue in your own time if you wish. I'm kind of rushing through it and trying to get the quest done as quickly as possible. I think in the letter it basically says that she feels the same affection for him as he does for her, and that Father Lawrence may be able to help them because he is sympathetic to their situation. So in a minute, we're gonna head to north, sort of northeast Varrock, as if you're going to the wilderness, and there's a church up there, it's on the map, and we're gonna ask Father Lawrence if he can recommend a course of action. How can he help resolve the situation? I mean, just a quick note while I'm still clicking through this dialogue. Just a quick one, if you are interested in quest guides, I've recorded a full series. The playlist is on the channel. So, you know, go and have a look at that, check it out. I've focused on the free-to-play quests, so end-to-end. As you can see with my current character, they're all done at the moment with an Ironman character. So they are done in a way that is end-to-end. No buying the quest items, it's get the quest items yourself and complete the quest, you know, start to finish. It's probably worth mentioning as well that although there's no actual monetary reward for this quest, the 5 quest points is really useful in trying to get enough quest points to do the Dragon Slayer 1 quest, which obviously you need to do in order to get Rune Chest Blade. So I highly recommend you do this quest because it's such an easy win. Now we're off, there you go, you can see the church, they're quick, and there's Father Lawrence. So we're going to give Father Lawrence a shout when my character just eventually gets there. He talks about giving a sermon. As you can see, his church is extremely busy with about 3 people. And he remembers that he's persuaded around eventually, and I think he now tells us that the apothecary can maybe help make a potion of living dead or something, which uses Cadava Berries, aptly named. And if Juliet drinks this, it'll make it look like she's dead. Then she'll get put in the crypt. When she's in the crypt, Romeo can come and collect her. And bish bash bosh, they can run away together. How romantic. Now, the Cadava Berries themselves, imps drop them. So you could have already found some by completing the Imp Catcher quest, of which there is definitely a quest guide on the playlist, or it popping up on the screen right now, so check that out if you haven't done Imp Catcher. But if you want to pick the berries, they are west of the mine that is southeast of Varrock. So head out the east gate, just past the bank, and head towards the mining area. I got a bit lost here, so you'll kind of see the screen cut shortly. There we go, and that is where the Cadava Berries are. You can see on the right hand of the map, in the top corner, that's just to the left-hand side, or the west of the mining area. I also stopped for some reason to kill a rat, sped the video up. And now we've got the Cadava Berries. Favaloran's pointed us to the apothecary, by the way, which you can also find on the map, which I will point out shortly. And we're going to head back to the center square, and then it's in the southwest, just behind the sword shop. If Varrock was split into four quadrants, starting at the center square where Romeo is, this is the southwest quadrant. There on the map, you can just see it there. The purple blob represents the apothecary, purple teardrop. And now we're going to go talk to him. Out of interest, you can buy strength, energy, and anti-poison potions. This is kind of useful for non-members because you can't do herbology, so you can't make your own potions at this point. The energy potions especially come in handy because, again, you can't train agility if you're playing free-to-play, which means your run runs out extremely quickly, especially if you've got armor on. So, yeah, that's the wrong option, though. Don't select that option. Select the other option to start talking about how we can create the cadaver potion. So we give him the cadaver berries, and he gives us the pink potion, the potion of death, or fake death, or whatever it's called. Now we head back to Juliet's house. It's not far from the apothecary. And once inside, click on Juliet and explain to her the plan. And also give her the potion. Now, shortly, once you've gone through the dialogue with her to explain what she needs to do, this will go into a short cutscene where Juliet drinks the potion and her friend there, or her cousin, I can't remember what she's called, comes in and pretends that she's dying, or she's died. And her dad comes and says, "Oh no, my daughter's died. How terrible." Pretty ridiculous. Possibly a reason why RuneScape 3 took this quest off. So this quest is only on old school. It's not on the new version of RuneScape. Been replaced with a sort of slightly different version of the quest, but it's no longer called Romeo and Juliet. Now, she's took the potion there, as you can see, and we're in the little cutscene. For some reason, I'm clicking through quite slowly here. Apologies. This is probably because I read quite slowly, and when I did the quest, I actually read the dialogue. So, he's a dad. What's all the noise? Oh my god, my daughter's dead. Blah, blah, blah. So, there we go. Now, we're back on the balcony, Juliet's gone, and we just need to go tell Romeo what the plan is. So, let's get down the stairs, and head back to Varrock Square to explain the sitch to Mr. Romeo. And there he is, wandering around, clueless as ever. As you can tell from the dialogue with him, and the fact his eyes seem to be pointing in different directions, he's a bit slow, shall we say. Anyway, he convinces us to chaperone him to the crypt, so we agree. Here we are, in the crypt. Romeo's got his flowers, and all he needs to do is go and collect Juliet. So we just wait for the camera to pan round. There she is, lying the picture of beauty on her tomb. All Romeo has to do is go over and wait for her to wake up. Surely even he couldn't mess this up, eh? She looks at and appears dead still, but that's because obviously she took the right potion. So Romeo's going to come over, collect his bride-to-be, and hightail out of here. In comes Philippa, and... Oh, what's this? He's forgotten about Juliet, and he likes Philippa. And that is the end of the quest, so Romeo leaves Juliet in the tomb, and runs off with her cousin Philippa. That's the end of the quest, 5 quest points later. So, thank you for watching. If it was at all helpful, please like, subscribe, and share the video, and leave a comment if there's anything else you'd like me to add. So watch out for my other quest guides, and peace out, guys.